We now have an edge relax tool, and what this lets us do is to edit bevels after the fact. In our example scene, we have this model that has several bevels on it. And we'll start by selecting this one here. And what we need to do is to select the entire radius of the bevel and then an edge on either side. With this selection, we'll run the edge relax tool and then click and drag in the viewport, and that radius can be changed. The propagate command will affect the adjacent parallel edges of your selection. The edge relax tool has all of the falloffs you expect in Modo built in. Ease in, ease out, linear, smooth, and custom. And then by reducing the propagate scale, you reduce the effect of the falloff. With the propagate side function, you can get even more control. By default, it's set to both, which means that both sides of the edge loop selected are affected. But you can also specify if you want the positive or negative sides. Also, we have the tension option. And what this does is essentially lets you completely redo the shape of that bevel. So you can change it to a concave fillet or even a chamfer. Lastly, there is a convergence option. And what this does is that instead of relaxing the edge, it will weld them together. You can also use the propagate function with this, and what this will do is weld adjacent parallel edges. Also, there is a mesh-op version of the tool. This is the Edge Relax tool in Modo 13.